Hi, I'm Katrine Horn, and I've got some food for thought for you. This is on how to deal with obnoxious people, because I think in most people's lives, we sometimes come across these people who are just so obnoxious that we find it really difficult to be around them. And sometimes these are people we can't avoid. So they could be family, or they could be work colleagues, they could even be bosses. So if somebody's being really obnoxious and you find that really difficult to deal with, here are some tips. Because if you can get away from that obnoxious person, then perhaps this is what you want to do. But as the world is far from perfect, we've just got to learn a way of dealing with it and of dealing with these obnoxious people in our lives, right? So if your boss is somebody who's really getting on your nerves because he's very demanding, or he or she is not at all in alignment with what you are, well, just ask yourself, do I really need to be in perfect symbiosis with this person to do what I need to do? Or is it possible to keep doing what I'm doing and what I want to do and what I need to do with this person here? Maybe you don't have to focus on him. Maybe you could focus on something else. So my idea is that if somebody's getting on your nerves, you could just go into the anger. You could respond to anger with anger. Like if somebody is telling you off, maybe instead of just justifying yourself, you could just sort of let it go through you. Like you could become conscious of the moment and say to yourself, oh, this person is really telling me off. Now, this is really getting on my nerves. So you've got a choice in that case, right? If you don't react immediately, but if you take a step back, become conscious of the situation, you can choose, do I want to answer him back? Do I want to start justifying myself? Or do I want to just let it wash over me? And sometimes you can find that actually the way that I spend the least energy on this is just to let him have his say. And I think you'll find that if you just let people get it off their chests, if you just let them be really angry and be really aggressive for a while, well, they'll just come down on their own, right? So let them get it all out, because it doesn't affect you, does it? It just washes over you. So you can just be standing there listening to the person or not. You can just let it all happen, knowing that you don't have to get engaged with this. You can just leave it there. You can just be an observer saying, oh, he's having a bad day, right? Because the thing about people who scold us is that it's not really about us. It's more about them. So what you could be thinking is, my boss, he's very, very angry and aggressive. Now, I wonder what happened in his life for him to have become like that. So if you take that step back and imagine this person as a baby, perhaps, or as a young boy or girl, and you start thinking, wow, they must have suffered so much in their lives to have become like that. You can start feeling perhaps not empathy with them, but you can start feeling compassion, right? You can start not blaming them or feeling annoyed with them. You can just let them be, right? You can let them have their scold, have their moment of aggression and whatever it is they're doing, and not be affected by it. Right? You can let them have everything they want, really, because it's not taking anything away from you, is it? Because when you walk out of the door, well, they're still left there with all their anger and aggression, aren't they? But you're not. You're still your own lovely person. So you can just walk out of that situation having nothing changed about you. Because if they've been scolding you because they are suffering, because they were treated badly when they were children, or they're having a bad day. It's got nothing to do with you. It's got everything to do with them. Do you see what I mean? So you don't have to take on other people's anger or aggression. You can just leave them be. And you can walk out of the situation feeling great because they were just having a bad day, if you see what I mean. If you want to learn more about this, maybe you'd want to visit my blog, or you can visit my website too. I hope to hear from you. Bye for now.